just a small town girl living in a lonely world. She took the midnight train going anywhere. Just a city boy, born and raised in South Detroit. He took the midnight train going anywhere.
I don't think we'd ever seen a player go from performing so poorly in one game of the finals to achieving such incredible heights the next. And if we're looking for a reason why the Bucks are firmly in control of this series, the Game 5 heroics of Jrue Holiday is the first place we'd start. They went right to him off the bat, and when Chris Paul got hung up on the screen, he got some daylight for the easy pull-up jumper. Then they cleared out and let him post up on Booker, turning us into a tough step-back long two that told us he hadn't stopped believing in himself. The Bucks went on an incredible mid-game run where they outscored the Suns by 30 points in 28 minutes, led by the play of Holiday. Watch how the defense plays this handoff from Lopez. They rotate Crowder over from Portis in the dunker spot, with Chris Paul jumping to provide even less incentive to throw that pass. This allows Holiday to blow right by him into the middle, where there is no rim protection on the nice double-pump lefty scoop. I don't blame the Suns for daring Holiday to shoot after his Game 4 performance, as CP3 goes under the screen, but it's too late. Holiday is red hot. And part of Chris Paul's poor play through much of this game was how he got around screens. Normally, he's much better than this, and Holiday makes them pay on the drop coverage. Into the third, as the Bucks began to build the lead, they attack the drop coverage again, and while the Suns are perfectly happy giving up this kind of shot, Jrue Holiday continued to kill them in the pick and roll. One of the most common sets by the Bucks is the high post entry to Giannis and the split cut by Middleton on the weak side. When Ayton bottles up the handoff attack, Middleton sees Booker bumping all the way down to the roll and skips it to the open Holiday, who wastes no time firing up the deep triple. In the third quarter, they run the same play, only this time it's Middleton setting the split screen, and while Booker blows it up with his excellent denial, forcing the Bucks to their next progression, the pick and roll for Jrue out top works well, where he drops the pull-up in over two good contests. To prove how much Holiday was in the flow and let the game come to him, he notched 13 assists as well, with this one on the sideline out of bounds. Watch how they set two screens for Giannis heading to the left block, and look at the deep position he gets, with Jrue putting the pass right on the money to allow Giannis the attack for the and one. Not only was he scoring out of the pick and roll, but he patiently waits for Crowder to bump down to Lopez before putting the ball just to the right of Portis, which gave him an extra step of room when Crowder started heading up to the wing initially. His use of the left hand to both score and pass is underrated. Check the baseline drive, hover in the air before firing the on-target pass right to Tucker wide open in his favorite corner. We have to discuss Jrue's defense and how he made some of his most profound impacts on the game. It's this type of coverage that's worn Chris Paul down and led them to a 3-2 series lead, which is why you need to have the right coverage when it comes to your life insurance policy. And that's where Policy Genius comes in. I spend countless hours analyzing each NBA team to give you the best information from many different sources, and Policy Genius makes it easy to compare quotes from over a dozen top insurers all in one place. You can save 50% or more on life insurance by comparing quotes with Policy Genius. Just like scoring in the NBA continues to rise year over year, life insurance rates can go up each year you wait to buy. Eligible applicants can get covered in as little as a week thanks to an award-winning policy option that swaps the standard medical exam requirement for a simple phone call. This exclusive policy was recently rated number one by Forbes, higher than options from Ladder, Ethos, and Bestow. I strive to give you the most fair and balanced analysis of the NBA. And since the experts at Policy Genius work for you, not the insurance companies, you can trust them to help you navigate every step of the shopping and buying process. You could save $1,300 or more per year on life insurance by using Policy Genius to compare policies. So head to policygenius.com/bball to get started now. And you'll have more peace of mind than the Suns fans who have to watch this segment on Holiday's defense leading up to the last minute of the game. In the second quarter, the Suns turn to Spain pick and roll, and watch what Holiday does. he switches on to Ayton and hustles to get below him. Then, when Tucker and Giannis screw up their part, he rotates over to contest with perfect verticality into a miss. When they needed someone to cool Devin Booker down in the third quarter, Mike Budenholzer put Holiday on him, and he promptly rips him at half court by beating Booker to the spot. And to add insult to injury, he looks to his teammates to sell that he's just setting up the offense before stepping behind the line to cold splash this in Booker's face. I just love how physical he was willing to get with DeAndre Ayton down low. He had to switch onto him a number of times and refused to be posted up on. Now, fault the Suns for not immediately isolating for Ayton on a low block, but look how Holiday gets low and takes away the position, ultimately leading to an embarrassing 24-second shot clock violation. Even when Holiday gets beat, he doesn't stop pursuing, with this awesome back tap that eliminated the surefire layup. More physicality, this time with Booker in the lane, and I have no doubt the extra energy exerted by Devin to get away from the defense led directly to him shooting this a foot short. In this critical possession deep into the fourth, they went back to Holiday guarding Booker, prompting the Suns to go completely away from their best score, which directly leads to Bridges having to create a shot for himself, which he can't hit, and the Bucks get a crucial stop. The Bucks have proven time and again in this series that when the offense isn't clicking, the solution is to generate second chance opportunities. Watch him sneak in here and just steal the rebound from Bridges to give them another possession and take even more time off the clock. Of course, even the best defenders get scored on, and it's worth noting that the Suns finally went to Booker starting on that left block and then coming around a series of screens for what is probably the second toughest three-pointer to hit, with Holiday on top of him, and yet this one drops clean through. But that brings us to the moment of truth. The Suns down one with the ball, under 25 seconds left. Everyone knew Booker was going to shoot this, so it wasn't a surprise that Jrue helps one pass away off the hottest guy in the gym. What was surprising was that Booker wandered over to that side of the floor, where all the help defense was. This allows Holiday to step in and just rip the ball away again from Booker. And I've got to tell you, from a coach's perspective, this was one of the last decisions you should make. With a chance to wind the clock down and force the defense to foul you, he instead saw an opening with only Chris Paul back and in an audacious moment throws a 25-foot lob to the rim where Giannis crushes it home plus the foul. This was as thrilling as it was foolish, and as we all know, fortune favors the bold. Holiday wasn't done, however, as he saves the day one more time by beating Booker to the spot and tipping the missed Giannis free throw up, allowing Giannis to very smartly tip this back to Middleton since Giannis wanted no part in grabbing that rebound and getting fouled again. With two consecutive mentally demoralizing losses for the Suns, I suspect that was their last gasp, and heading into the hostile environs of Milwaukee's home arena will be too much for them to overcome. And it was all because guys like Jrue Holiday came to the rescue, a true testament to staying in the moment, keeping your focus, and never, ever stop believing.